I'm Jamie.
Hello, my sweet friends. I'm so glad you came to play with us today.
I have a feeling right here. It's the best feeling, like music to my ears. I wait for it to happen, 'cause it happens every day. And when it starts to happen, this is what I say. I feel love, lovey-dovey, lovey-do, lovey me and lovey you. I am happy when I'm with you. Tell me you are too. In fact, I'm so happy, it makes me want to wiggle and move my body. Would you like to wiggle with me? Okay, let's wiggle. We're gonna wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and stop. We're gonna wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and stop. Let's take a big breath in. Smell the flowers. They're not real flowers, make believe. And let's blow out the candles. Again, smell the flowers. And now let's blow out the candles. You ready to wiggle again? Okay, we're gonna wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and stop. We're gonna wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and wiggle and stop. Hands up into the air. Wave to the universe. Hello, universe. Ah, felt so good. The air we breathe is sweet and good. It's in both me and you. It's how we live upon this earth. With all the creatures, too. We share the earth with so many wonderful things, like air and water and dirt. And we share the air, water, and dirt with so many things, too, like animals and people and bugs. Oh my goodness! Do you hear that sound?
Hi, I'm Pickles.
Hi, Pickles. It's so good to see you.
Yes, well, I heard that sound.
What sound?
That sound.
What sound?
That sound!
Every time we hear that sound, we know that Pickles is coming.
That's me.
Yes, that's you. I'm glad that happens because I get to be with you.
And I'm glad that happens because I get to be with you, Jamie, and all my friends.
And we're really happy, too, because we know that Pickles always has something new to tell us. Do you have something you'd like to share with us today?
Yes, I planted a garden.
That's wonderful. What did you plant?
Well, I planted salad.
That's funny. You're funny. You mean you planted lettuce?
Yes, I did. I planted lettuce, all different colors. And then I found an earthworm.
Oh my goodness. Earthworms are so, so important to the earth. They have such an important job. They help in so many ways.
Yes, they do.
My friend Jack just planted a garden too. Would you like to go on an adventure with Jack?
Yes, I would.
Me too. Let's go.
Guess what we're going to be doing today?
Can I grab it?
You can grab it. Go ahead. Feel it?
This jar makes snow.
It does make snow.
That's a lot.
That is a lot. Where does it go? Goes in the pot.
What about this one?
Ooh, a little bit.
Look, I need a lot.
Okay, you do a lot. A little bit more.
That's a white Celsius dirt.
Yeah, a thousand dirts. One more big one. Whoa. Whoa, that's great. Ooh.
It is.
Finally. Okay. Whoa! Look at all the worms! Look at all the worms! Oh my goodness.
Is that the most we need?
That's the most we need.
Uh-huh.
That's all.
What are you going to do with this? Whoa, that's a lot. One, two, brown, green, brown, green, brown. Yeah.
Ready? Then we put the dirt on top. We have one more thing to do. What do we do now?
Water.
You are so smart.
This is a big one.
This hand here and this hand here. Right here. I'll help you. Whoa. Whoa. It doesn't need a lot. Just a little, right? Ooh. Ooh. You know who's really happy right now? Oh, the worms. Oh my goodness. In a little while, these are going to get puffy.
Bye.
Bye, everybody. See you next time.
Jack and I had so much fun planting the other day. I love the feeling of fresh, clean dirt or soil in my hands. This is a plant. It's called an herb. I'm going to move it from this small pot into a bigger pot so it can grow big and healthy. This is an herb called basil. It smells so good. It reminds me of spaghetti. That's because many people like me use basil when they make their spaghetti sauce. Turn it upside down. Plant it in. Ooh, look at all the roots. These are the roots. Just when it's all ready, I make a big mess. There we go. Do you know what comes next? Did you say water? You're right. So now, we water the basil. Whee! It's raining on the basil. Really good. Does that feel good, basil? Not too much, just enough. I'll be watering this plant every 3 days, and we can watch it grow together. If the soil gets too dry, the plant won't grow. Our friends, the earthworms, also can't grow if there's no water in the soil. Would you like to learn more about our friends, the earthworms? I have a friend. His name is Professor Cliff. He's what you call an entomologist. I know, that's a really big word. An entomologist is a person who studies bugs. Can you believe it? Is that the coolest thing? Cliff, are you ready to talk a little bit more about our friends, the earthworms? Okay. Take it away, Cliff.
Meet my little friend, the earthworm. Here he is crawling around. His head is over here. And his tail is right over there.
What do earthworms eat for breakfast? Well, they like to eat dried up dead leaves. and they turn it into dirt or soil. Each one of these little bands around his body is called a segment. Each one has its own set of muscles.
How do earthworms know where they're going if they have no eyes? Well, they're sensitive to the light. So what they do is they crawl around and they look for places that are dark. So you see the head over here is moving around, and he's trying to squirm a bit until he finds a spot that is darker. So this earthworm is crawling around. He's trying to get off it, and he really can't see. He just doesn't like being on this brick, and now he fell down off the brick, and he's hiding under the shade of this leaf. And he knows he's in the shade because there's no light. And he squirms. He squirms until he falls off, and there he goes.
Oh, doll, look at you. You look so thirsty. How about you and I have a nice fresh drink of water together? You like that? What, you like that? There you go, sweetheart. Doesn't that feel better? Look at you. So gorgeous. The other plants around here should look so happy. Oh, excuse me.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm. You live down in the dirt, so busy with your work, helping the earth all day. Making tunnels as you go, not too fast and not too slow, eating stones and little bugs along the way. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm. You don't have eyes to see, but like the bumblebee, you help to make the vegetables grow. Making room for roots and air and flowers everywhere, for carrots and corn and broccoli in a row. Even if we don't see you, we know that you are there, doing what you were born to do and doing it everywhere. Is the very best thing, making me want to sing. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm. You live down in the dirt, so busy with your work, helping the earth all day. Making tunnels as you go, not too fast and not too slow, eating stones and little bugs along the way. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm.
Pickles, you're in the garden.
Look at these beautiful flowers. They're wonderful.
I'm not looking at the beautiful flowers. I'm not looking at anything. I'm not in the mood.
Would you like to tell me why you're not in the mood?
Not really. I'm afraid you're gonna laugh at me. Then I would really be sad.
Oh, Pickles, I'd never laugh at you, especially about your feelings. That's not a very nice thing to do. I'm right here if you wanna talk to me about it.
I wanna be an earthworm. I don't want to be Pickles anymore. It's not fun being me.
What's wrong with being Pickles?
Well, I'm not wiggly or brown. I can't make tunnels in the dirt. I can't make fertilizer. I don't help the earth. Not at all. And that makes me sad.
I'm going to tell you a story about a friend of mine. This friend is one of the best kinds of friends. Always helpful, always there when I need to talk, and there when I don't feel like talking, and always there when I want to play. That's right. My friend is a beautiful color and is always telling stories that make me smile. And my friend likes to dance and wiggle and jump. And one day we went to the beach and my friend made a wonderful sandcastle with driftwood and seashells and lots of tunnels. And later that day, we helped the earth. We cleaned up and threw all the recyclables into the recycle bin.
That's a very good friend. But it's an earthworm because they build tunnels and they wiggle and they help the earth.
It's not an earthworm, Pickles. It's you. You did all those things. You love to dance and jump, and you like to take care of the earth whenever you can. I love you for all those things. But I love you especially because there is no one else in the whole wide world just like you. There may be others that look like you or do the same things that you do. Yet we are all different and beautiful because of this. That's a wonderful thing to be happy about.
I did all those things. Wow, I am special, like an earthworm.
Yes, like an earthworm. But never forget the special things about you that make you shine.
I like to shine. See, I'm shining.
Oh, Pickles, you're so much fun to be with.
Ha! I'm a wide-mouthed bullfrog. I fly. What do you eat?
Hello, my sweet friends. Welcome to my idea workshop. This is your idea workshop. Well, today we're going Oh my goodness! Look who it is! It's Wiggly Poo! We were just about to talk about you. Look at you wiggling. You're such a wiggly worm.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggly worm.
Hi, my goodness.
So busy.
Look
with
at you,
worm,
my little wiggly worm.
Helping the earth.
We're going to make our own wiggly worm today. With everything that you have in your own home. Not only is it good for color exploration, but it's also a learning tool that goes with our Wiggly Worm episode. Here's where the Wiggly Worm eats.
There's where the Wiggly Worm poops.
Are you ready? Let's begin. All art activities require adult supervision. Not all materials used are suitable for the youngest preschooler, so discretion is advised. And, as you will see, simple preparation is required before passing it on to your child. Thanks, everyone, and have fun. Let's get started. For a palette, I like recycling plastic that works well for paint. This one's great because it has a shallow well for water.
and a nice size area for the paint. This is children's non-toxic acrylic paint that you can purchase at Michael's or online. For this project, we can't use tempera because it won't adhere to the fabric and will chip off. Put a quarter size amount of each color, red, yellow, and blue, on the palette. Grab a paintbrush and pour about a quarter inch water into the well. Next, you will need string. I cut these a little short. Cut them into 5-inch lengths and put aside. To make your 1.5 to 2-inch size balls, you will need 5 14-inch square pieces of thin weight aluminum foil. Grab a piece in your hands and squish it until it resembles a ball. Perfection is not necessary. If you have an older preschooler, 4.5 to 5 years old, let them squish the balls. It's not advised to give the foil to the younger preschoolers. Now you will need a woman's size sock. This is an ankle sock, but you can use a tube sock. Just keep it white. Then just start plopping the balls in the sock. Okay, grab the first ball, pull the sock over the ball, and with one of your string pieces, tightly tie it around the ball, making a knot, trimming off the excess string. I'm using wax-coated string. It's not necessary to use, but it's a great craft material that really holds the knot, and you can use it for a lot of creative projects and crafts. You can get it in craft stores or online. They come in really great colors too. As you can see, this part of the activity, as with all our Giggles and Stardust preschool age art activities, is performed by the grown-up. Please let the child watch and be involved with the setup, but this is not meant for them to do, obviously. Once all the balls are placed and knotted, grab the tip of the sock and gather a little nib in one hand. Grab a string and tie around the nib. It might take a little maneuvering, but you'll figure it out. This is the mouth of our wiggly worm. Now for the exciting part. Grab the other end of the sock and cut off, leaving about a quarter to a half an inch. This is where the wiggly worm poops. This is a very exciting topic with our preschoolers. It's all about the potty. They are most likely in some stage of potty training, talking about, reading about, laughing about, and even crying about this stage is a major part of their world. Our wiggly worm is a useful tool when revisiting the potty training process, hence my potty mouth. Okay, so there you go with the preparation part of this activity. Dip the paintbrush in water to get it wet. Once you give the brush over to the child, let them do as they please. Try not to control the process. The three primary colors, when mixed all together, make brown. And that's the idea. Let them mix up the paint, or whatever they want to do. They may just brush on a dab of red and say, "All done," or they mix all the three colors together right away. The color of the worm will eventually become brown if the paint stays wet. Just advise it to keep putting the brush in the water.
Thank you. Then once you have the red on it, you could always put more red on, then I'd put the blue on. Do-do-do-do-do. Your child's going to put it on any way they want, which is just fine. Now for the yellow. Or if they wanted to add more red, or if they wanted to add more blue, or if they wanted to add more yellow, it's whatever they want. So there you go. There is your earthworm. And of course we want to paint the poopy area. And the mouth area, maybe you want to make that just yellow.
So there we have it, our wiggly worm. Let it dry, then go have fun putting on their own puppet shows, exploring its wiggly movement, or just putting it on the shelf to admire. Because acrylic paint is a thicker consistency than tempera, you may want to be more protective of the clothes and area being used. Thank you for doing our art project together. I hope you all had fun. I know I did.
Well, my sweet friends, we've come to the end of our show. Thank you for spending time with us today. I hope you had as much fun as I did. And I'd like to thank my special guests, Aunt Gloria and Madison Dragonson and Pickles.
Always remember how special you are, and there is no one in the whole wide world exactly like you. And all the things that make you different are the very things that make you sparkle. Like Stardust. I love you. Love you, Jamie.
See you next time!